normal for other journalists.
Calm down, you freak.
What was that? Guess we showed them.
Were you able to clear out those ghouls?
Took care of those ghouls that were giving you trouble.
You did? That's great news.
If anyone could figure out a good use for it. All routes and rumors lead to Bunker Hill. That's one way to keep out uninvited guests.
Doc.
Doc Weathers is guaranteed to patch up any brute.
I need some supplies, Doctor.
You got the caps?
Seems like the kind of place you could kick back, right?
You can't only take 10 cans. You know, it tastes better than that old Graham or Brahmin that's been sitting out in the sun for days. There are people out there who are hungry. You just gotta sell up the product a bit more.
I'm sorry, but 10 cans is all I can commit to right now. It was selling like crazy for a while there, but there's been talk about people getting sick.
People get sick all the time. That has nothing to do with my product. Besides, I mean, I'm only selling the meat you people bring me. If there's something wrong with it, it's your own damn fault.
Oh, so now it's my fault? Forget it, the deal's off. You want to sell your product to the people out there? Then you can get out there and do it your damn self.
What? Hey, come on.
Hey.
Got some stuff for sale.
Please.
Care to have a look?
You'll be back.
What was that in there about people getting sick?
Theo got that old cannery up and running about a year or so back, and convinced me and some of the other traders to start bringing his cans around. It was all good and well for a while, but in the past couple months, I've had people complain about getting sick after eating it. Don't get me wrong, not like people dying or anything, just, I don't know, the sales have slumped off and Theo's gotten more uppity. So, can I interest you in a trade?
Where did you get that vault suit?
Never been to 81, I take it. I grew up there, but left to be a traitor. Here, let me show you where it is. Nice Pip-Boy, by the way. Mine was a piece of junk. Threw it out years ago. Care to see what I've got for sale?
Do you want to set up a permanent shop? I know the perfect place.
I'm confused. I'm sure I have something you're looking for. You should have a look.
Do you want to set up a permanent shop?
You've got yourself a deal.
Bitch. Ah, you're back. Are you interested in buying some of Long Neck Lakowski's delicious canned meat?
Sure.
Have a look. But if you bite it, you bought it. Welcome to have a look, but stay out of the old basement. It isn't safe down there.
through. Perfect. Perfect.
Calm down, you freak. Calm down, you freak.
It's so quiet. Could consider themselves a success until someone threatened their life. Me? I'm very serious. Someone needs to drain this place in a serious way.
Got it. That's it.
You to stay out of the basement. Now that you know my little secret, I'll just have to kill you.
What was Everyone in the Commonwealth will know. The Minutemen are back.
Hi.
Now that we have the armory back, you can resupply here whenever you run low on supplies. Anything you need right now?
Let me see what you've got.
Here's what we have on hand.
Broadcasting across the Commonwealth. Any minute man in the area, there's a settlement that's been raided by super mutants. Please respond if you can help. You're tuned to Radio Freedom, voice of the Minutemen. All quiet here. Stay tuned for Minutemen orders. Radio Freedom, broadcasting all day, all across the Commonwealth. All quiet, which is how we like it. Stay safe out there, people. Thank you. Radio Freedom, broadcasting all day, all across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report. Keep it tuned here for updates.
Yes.
Well, take your time. Let her keep me fed.
This shouldn't take long. Get some, motherfucker.
Thank you.
Nice.
Welcome to the Slog. We're the only tarberry bog in the Commonwealth. So what do you think of the place?
It's pretty clever, making a tarberry bog out of an old swimming pool.
I appreciate your saying so. When I came across this place, it was the first time I'd seen anything like it. It seemed like a shame not to use it for something. You probably noticed it's only ghouls around here. I used to live in Diamond City, until that rat bastard mayor threw me and all the other ghouls out. I decided that we ghouls should have a place where we could feel welcome, and that's mainly why I started up this farm.
It looks like you've done well for yourselves.
It's a good start, yeah, and I'm proud of all the work we've done. Still, I think we can do more. What if this place could be more than just a refuge for ghouls who aren't welcome elsewhere? What if it could also be an example of what we can do when we put our minds to something and work together? We want this to be a place that everyone looks forward to visiting, with smiling faces, good bargains, and great produce. Maybe we can make people take a second look, you know? Maybe then they'd see that we're not monsters.
I think it's a great idea.
You really think so? Because if you do, we could definitely use some help.
We can't sell tarberries without traders, and trade caravans need safe roads. There's a gang of super mutants that's been preying on anyone who comes near their turf, including traders. It'd be a great help to us if you could take care of those brutes once and for all.
I'll take care of those super mutants. I promise.
Good. I didn't know what we were going to do.
Fresh tarberries.
You sure managed to find your fair share of trouble, don't you?
It usually finds me.
Hey, I'm not one to judge. Honestly, it's just nice to not be doing it alone for a change. In my line of work, things tend to get pretty hairy. I've been shot at, poisoned, nearly executed. Heck, until recently they called the lockup in Diamond City the Piper Suite. Anything for a story, I suppose.
Someone poisoned you?
You kidding me? I barely had the paper going before I got poisoned. First time, I'd just published an article about this cartel of caravans that had been driving up food prices in the city. Article went over well, even got a boycott of their goods started in town, so I figured I'd pop over to the Dugout Inn for a victory drink. I'd already taken a swig by the time I realized something was wrong. Vadim, he wasn't at the bar. The beer tasted off, even more so than usual. And I started feeling real woozy. I don't know what he slipped me, but I knew I had to get it out. I'm looking around for something, and there it is, the still. And I just start chugging moonshine. Honestly, I'm still not totally convinced it was better than just dying from the poison, but it worked. And while I was passed out on the floor, security managed to grab the bartender. He eventually ratted out his bosses, and they all got to share some time in the pen.
You've led an exciting life.
Sure have. But honestly, now that I'm out here with you, I feel like I'm just getting started. Getting in trouble is what folks like us do. I mean, you and I are out here putting ourselves at risk so people in the Commonwealth can have a chance at a better life. Not for praise or reward or glory, but because it's right. I just wanted to let you know I'm real happy to be along for the ride.
I wouldn't want it any other way. I like having you close.
Thanks, Blue. That's awfully sweet and unexpected of you. So, you want to get out of here? Jealous of folks who could craft something other than paragraphs. We're not alone. some way to keep out uninvited guests.
Going down.
Probably have something you can use.
Yes.
Huh?
I love it here.
I knew you would help us.
Well, you're still alive. That either means you haven't gone after those super mutants yet, or... good news?
Those super mutants won't be bothering you again.
I guess you were the right person for the job, huh? Thanks, friend. By the way... Shazia,
people have been complaining a bit about the bed situation.